السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى we'll continue with سورة الصافات and we'll go through verses 75 to 82 from سورة الصافات, سورة number 37. So open your Mus'haf inshallah and we'll start with the recitation. As usual, we recite and you recite after me to learn how to recite, and then after that we go through the verses inshallah. If you don't know how to recite, it's okay. Just try to imitate and take this or start the path of learning how to recite the Quran inshallah, and wait for the explanation of the verses inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the reward of being in the gatherings of the Quran. Okay, start with ayah number 75. Ayah number 75. Repeat after me, inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Walaqad nadana Nuhun falani'mal mujibun. ونجيناه وأهله من الكرب العظيم وجعلنا ذريته هم الباقين وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على نوح في العالمين إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين ثم أغرقنا الآخرين ولقد نادانا دال with سكون قلقلة and the cough is heavy and the before that and after that is light ولقد نادانا نوح تنوين after it فائز إخفاء and kind of I don't want to say smile when you're doing it but I'm just it needs to be light نوح like this فلنعم المجيبون ونجيناه وأهله من الكرب العظيم من الكاء the calf is light and then the ra is heavy من الكرب العظيم and the ball is heavy. وَجَعَلْنَا the lamb وَجَعَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُ هُمُ الْبَاقِينَ وَتَرَكْنَا the ta is light, the ra is heavy and the calf is light وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ سَلَامٌ عَلَى نُوحٍ this is إظهار we show the تنوين سَلَامٌ نُغُنَّ على نوح تنوين after إخفاء is إخفاء نوح في العالمين إن نون شدة كذلك نج تجيم with سكون قلقلة نجزي المحسنين إنه نون شدة takes two counts من عبادنا المؤمنين ثم ميم شدة أغرقنا أغرقنا ألف is light, the غاء is heavy, the غين is heavy, the راء is heavy, قاف is heavy but it's قلقلة. So just make sure that the همزة is A not A. But then they make the غاء heavy. أغرق أغرق. The قاف is قلقلة, you move it. أغرقنا الآخرين. الآخرين the همزة is light and then the خاء is heavy. The first ayah, وَلَقَدْ نَادَانَا نُوحٌ فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ. And indeed, Nuh invoked us, and we are the best of those who answer the request. So this is in the surah. It will start mentioning the prophets of Allah, some of the prophets of Allah. For great reason and wisdom behind that is, as in the first 74 verses in the surah, talks about many different things. How that establishing the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the believers versus the disbelievers and many good benefits to learn, and as a result of that to show them in practical example the believers versus the disbelievers and the prophets of Allah, to give the comfort to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam with regards to the what's mentioned about the previous messengers of Allah. So, and that's always important when we look into the Quran, when the stories of the messengers of Allah are mentioned and the struggle between the people of the truth and the people of falsehood, pay attention to the verses before and the verses after. So, the verses talks about the believers versus the disbelievers and the belief in Allah and the oneness of worship of Allah and shaitan, how he deceives human beings unless those who are saved by the mercy of Allah to be guided, and the rewards that is waiting for the believers versus the punishment from Allah, and companionship and the importance of it, and how they would lead one another either to their own destruction or to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then after all of that is mentioned, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ نَادَانَا نُوحٌ فَلَا نِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ. That Nuh indeed, he invoked us. نَادَانَا, and nida is to call upon someone. And Nuh alayhi salam called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after he gave da'wah to his people 1,000 years minus 50, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, 950 years he's been calling people to Allah, calling people to the tawheed, calling people to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here the benefit that we learn of what Nuh alayhi salam, he was very patient and consistent in calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after all of this long period of time, only few accepted the message. So it's not about the majority, it's not about the followers, it's about being firm upon the haqq, the truth. And after he called his people that long period of time, then he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it's mentioned in Surah Al-Qamar, إِنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصِرْ. Oh Allah, I am defeated, so give me victory or send victory upon me and help me. So he was not going after his own benefit, but he was doing that for the sake of Allah. As Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said, فَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ لِغَضَبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was angry with his people as a result of their prophet was angry with them. And that's why no people will be successful if their prophet is angry with them. And that's what happened to the people of Bani Israel, and how Musa alayhi salam was angry with them. And how, comparing that to the companions radiallahu anhum, when the Prophet alayhi salam died, then he was pleased with them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed this ummah. So Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informing us about his messenger of Allah, slave of Allah, Nuh alayhi salam, the first messenger of Allah. Adam alayhi salam is the first prophet. Nuh alayhi salam is the first messenger. And after he called his people that long period of time, then he says, made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save him. And you find someone nowadays of calling someone to the making da'wah to Allah, and just in 5 minutes he would make dua against him that he did not accept the truth. This is not valid. You know, people need to be patient with others and with having the kindness and the goodness, inviting others to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when we take this verse with the other verses that talked about Nuh alayhi salam, like in Surah Nuh, for example, how he called his people during the day and during the night and at all times, and فَلَمْ يَزِدْهُمْ دُعَاءُ إِلَّا فِرَارًا. They did not dua illa firara. He said that the more I call them to Allah, the more they run away from me. And he's a messenger of Allah. And you find, you know, this is how the norm is. And he was consistently still calling them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ. How great is the acceptance. We are the best of those who answer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best to answer. the invocation and the seeking of help, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of all things. And everything happens by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ And we saved him, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ And his family, his people, مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ From this great distress. And the great distress is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the people of Nuh with, which is they were all drowned, as it's mentioned also in the verses. So when Nuh alayhi salam, he sought the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبِّ انصُرْنِي عَلْ قَوْمِ الْمُفْسِدِينَ Oh Allah, help me against those corrupted ones. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he mentioned it, فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِبُونَ in general. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that answers your dua. And he's the one that hears your invocation. So turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and don't be in haste. Don't think that I've made dua and where's the acceptance? The person is accepted, his dua is accepted as long as he doesn't say that. And leave the matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be a true servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Nuh alayhi salam and his people and his family and those who followed him. And this is the meaning of al-ahl. And that's what Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, it was only the what's left afterwards are the lineage of Nuh alayhi salam, because everyone else was destroyed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ From this great distress, the punishment from Allah that came unto his people. وَجَعَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُ هُمُ الْبَاقِينَ Which means, and his progeny, them we made the survivors. Right, so the progeny of Nuh alayhi salam are the ones that were saved and none else. And there are things where it's mentioned in the hadith when Nuh alayhi salam, he put everyone in the ship. It was said that those who followed him, they died, except what's the progeny of or the lineage of Nuh alayhi salam. That's what is meant by وَجَعَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُ هُمُ الْبَاقِينَ Right, so whether it's three, the father of this and the father of that, like, and you find this in the books of Tafsir and from Israeliyat and things like this, where the details of that is not necessarily benefiting, but it's sufficient for us to know that all the disbelievers were drowned, and the lineage of Nuh alayhi salam, they continued to be, and this is that's why everybody on the face of earth are from the lineage of Nuh عليه السلام ونجيناه أهله من الكرب العظيم وجعلنا ذريته هم الباقين His lineage are the ones that stayed after him وتركنا عليه في الآخرين Which means and this verse will be repeated in these stories and left for him among generations to come at later times وتركنا عليه That means and left for him a goodly remembrance among generations to come in later times وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left in the lineage to come the good mention of Nuh alayhi salam, that people loved him and believing in him as he's a messenger of Allah. And this kalima or this word that stayed for the rest of humanity's life to be mentioned him with good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this for him. As a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Nuh alayhi salam for his patience. And no matter how long Nuh alayhi salam lived, it's considered to be nothing compared to the entire lifespan on the face of earth. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ سَلَامٌ عَلَى نُوحٍ فِي الْعَالَمِينَ Which means, and this is also going to be repeated after the mention of every prophet, peace be upon Nuh alayhi salam among the alameen, among the mankind and the jinn and all that exists. So سلام على نوح so peace upon نوح and السلام is for him to be saved from any harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him in this life and in the hereafter إن كذلك نجزي المحسنين indeed this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward or recompense المحسنين the good doers and it's also going to be repeated so these verses since it's going to be repeated from one messenger to the other this is why it's mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them face all kinds of difficulties and trials in their life. and they were left with good praise, and they are secure, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the peace and the goodness in this life and in the hereafter. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the like of that, He rewards the muhsineen. So His recompense, the reward to Nuh alayhi salam, was not because of just, it's not something unique for Nuh alayhi salam. This is also for those who follow the like of Nuh alayhi salam in doing what? In being upon the Tawheed and the Deen of Allah, and in conveying the message. And that's, it's clearly stated in the Quran. So when إِنَّكَ ذَلِكَ نَجِزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, this is how we recompense, this is how we reward those who among our slaves, they do good. They do good in obedience to Allah, in calling others to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, indeed he is from our believing slaves. Nuh alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising him. How he established al-Iman, one of the great messengers of Allah. ثُمَّ أَغْرَقُنَا الْآخَرِينَ, then we made the rest drown. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused the rest to drown as a punishment for them, and they were given so much time in the da'wah, 1,000 years minus 50, 950 years, and they did not accept the truth. So they deserved to what happened to them. They were drowned as a punishment in this life and in the hereafter, which is worse for them, that they will be in hellfire forever. So this is because of their kufr, because of their disbelief. When we look at the ayat how the ayat means, وَلَقَدْ نَادَانَا نُوحٌ فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ, which means indeed وَلَقَدْ, and as we heard before, وَلَقَدْ, the قَدْ is much more stronger than قَدْ. So this is stressing the meaning, indeed, verily, no doubt, right? وَلَقَدْ نَادَانَا, النَّادَانَا from نُون دَلْ وَوْ, which means called us, invoked us. And that you can call someone that is less than you, and you can call someone that is higher than you. And the same word is used, but of course, a different types of calling. So you can call your son, right? You can call even an animal, with certain noises and things like this. But to call what is above, here it refers from the slave of Allah calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means with dua. Making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَقَدْ نَادَانَا نُوحٌ, this is Nuh alayhi salam, فَلَا نِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ, therefore, fa is then, فَلَا لَمْ, here is لَمُ التَّوْكِيد, stressing the meaning, which means also indeed, surely, نِعْمَ, as mentioned before, is the best. Something that gives the meaning of what a great thing, praising something. So this is called مَتْح. Like you say, نِعْمَ, الرجل أحمد, what a great man is Ahmed. So, and the opposite of ni'ma is bi'sa. So there's in linguistics, in grammar also, they talk about the usloob of ni'ma and bi'sa. Bi'sa is the opposite, what a worse person that is, what a worse situation that is. Come from the same three letters, and the ni'ma and the favors of Allah and so on comes from this, which means the good state that a person is in, which is basically the ni'ma. So, فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ, what a great responders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best to respond to the dua. الْمُجِيبُونَ, and this is the responders, from جِيم وَاوْ بَاءْ. And then مُجِيب is one. الْمُجِيب is one. And الْإِجَابَة is to respond. And it comes also from the meaning of something that is, when something is cut off from something else. And it's used for al-jawb is when something, a piece of earth is cut off. So this basically when you respond to someone. So فَلَا نِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ, and we saved him. وَنَجَّي from نُون جِيم وَاوْ, saved him. And the نُون أَلِف, we, refers to the royal we or so. And the ha is, refers to نُوح عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ, and also comes النَجَاء is to, something is separated from something. Something is separated from something, and that is the najah of the salvation or to be saved comes from. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ, and his family, from the same three letters, which is his people and his family. من الكرب العظيم. From the kerb. الكرب is a distress. From كاف راء باء. And it refers to something when something is very difficult, distress, affliction. And الكربة is when someone is in that state of misery. If you look into linguistically, where does it come from? It's like when the earth is upside down. When كرب الأرض is when they dig in the earth. So as if it has like the same feeling in one's heart. That's how the distress do to the person, as if he is in a storm inside. Right. So الكرب العظيم, the great كرب or the great distress. And from عين ضاء ميم, وجعلنا, and we made from جعل ذريته, his offspring. ذرية from ذال راء راء. And ذرية is the offspring, the lineage, the children. هم الباقين, they are the باقين, they are the survivors. From باء قاف ياء. Yeah. الله سبحانه وتعالى is الباقي, the everlasting one. And البقاء is when something stays, you know, that doesn't get perished. And بقية is what is left. بقية الله خير لكم. الباقيات الصالحات, what stays forever. So هم الباقين. وتركنا, and we left. From ترك, when you leave something. عليه, for him, for him. في الآخرين, in the آخرين, in the later generations. That means we kept for him the good praise and the mention. The name of Nuh عليه السلام is in matters of goodness. في الآخرين. Look, for example, Fir'aun, how he had all kinds of desire in this world and status and everything, and those who praised him during his lifetime out of his fear and things like this, but then how he's mentioned afterwards, cursed by everyone. And Nuh alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought the praise, and what matters is the praise of the believers, of course, not the praise of those who are ignorant and forgetful. في الآخرين, those who left. سلام, peace be upon, from سين لام ميم, على نوح, upon Nuh alayhi salam, في العالمين, in the worlds, from عين لام ميم. إن كذلك, indeed we, this thus, كذلك, like اسمه إشارة, when you point into something, نجزي, from جيم زاي ياء, the reward, the recompense, المحسنين, the good doors, from حاء سين نون. إن كذلك نجزي المحسنين. إنه, indeed he, من, from من عبادنا, from our slaves, from عين باء ذال, المؤمنين, the believing ones, from ألف ميم نون. ثم, then, أغرقنا, from غرق, we drowned, we caused them to drown. الغرق is when someone is drowned. وأغرقنا آل فرعون. So then we drowned. الآخرين, the rest, or the others. So it's the believers versus الآخرين. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned as the rest, the others, to show how of no value they are. When a person is not upon al-iman and the faith, he's of no value whatsoever. He's not helped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He brought it to himself when they turn away from the deen of Allah and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them for. So as you see from the verses, this is what's going to be followed by the what mentioned about Ibrahim alayhi salam and some other prophets as a way to give comfort to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in his mission as calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to see that the struggle in this life would never end. It ends by the end of this life. There's always that struggle between the people of the haqq, the people of the truth, versus the people of falsehood. And whoever thinks that it's going to be over with, they are deceiving themselves. And it's basically the ways of the people of falsehood to convince the believers, at least, that the struggle will end, so that the believers will give up on continuing the struggle. So that the disbelievers or the people upon falsehood would then defeat them and be superior over them for the evil to be widespread on the face of earth. So what ought to be done is, the believers, they should continue the struggle. What struggle? The struggle to be upon al-Iman, faith, and the struggle is to convey the truth according to the way of the Prophet ﷺ, and to turn away from the plots and the evil ways of those who want to spread corruption on the face of earth. So that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, to give him that firm steadfastness upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we see here, that it's all from Allah, and when you rely upon Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you and keep you steadfast, and that's the real goodness in this life, is to be firm upon al-Iman, because it's going to end at the end. So that's what matters. What matters for the believers is they do not change the truth. So as long as they're upon the truth, as Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, when someone asked him, you know, ala tara, don't you see how the people of dalala or people of deviations are superior, and how they are superior over the people of guidance? And he said, you know, when he said to he replied to him that they are not, as long as our hearts are upon guidance. As long as our hearts are upon guidance, that means they did not defeat us. So as long as the hearts are upon steadfastness, upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this is what matters, and this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from the believers. As far as being established in this life or not, then it's this is by the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he does this according to his wisdom subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's what Nuh alayhi salam was upon. Also, as we see that what matters is the end of things and how the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never changes, and you see the characteristics are mentioned in كَذَلِكَ نَجِي muhsinin. So be among the muhsinin and leave the matter to Allah. Be among the believers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of your affairs. And be patient, and do patience till the end of time, and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Barakallahu feekum. We'll stop here inshallah. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala Saturday inshallah. And tonight is the night of Jumu'ah, so also the night and the day of Jumu'ah is to give it its attention, and inshallah following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. صلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.